Showtime Onliners, huwag na nating patagalin pa. Let's all welcome our special guest all the way from London, one of the members of the British-Norwegian boy band A1, Mark Reed.
Yeah, hello, my friend.
Hey.
The background.
Oh, yes.
What is up,
oh, yes.
Yes.
Hello, Showtime Onliners and all you Medlang people. It's great to see you. And great to see you, Eris and Janine. Really nice to see you.
Is it all right if we call you Mark?
You can call me anything you like. I mean, a lot of people call me Mark A1. I'm surprised I haven't actually changed my passport to say Mark A1. Because I think I'm in most of my friends' contacts page as Mark A1, even though we've known each other since school. But yeah, hey, can I just say, Eris, I'm loving that shirt. I feel like I need to undo a few buttons just to
relaxed. Yeah.
There we are. There we go.
What can Better. You do this? Just put the button on the tree. On the tree.
Okay. I like it. Okay, sorry about that. Sorry about that, Janine. You carry on.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. It's all right.
By the way, Mark, before anything else, I would like to apologize because I'm not good speaking in English, but I will try my best to interview you.
Okay, you're doing absolutely fantastic. You're doing amazing. I'm not that good. I'm not that good in Tagalog, so you know. I'll do my best as well. I will do my best.
Okay.
Yeah. So we hope you go easy on us, of course. Before we begin our chit chat, of course, can I ask about your background?
Do you mean my background, like where I grew up, where I was born?
My virtual background. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Okay, I was born in Kingston in this virtual background is my A1 background. There you go. I could possibly change it to this one. What we got? Smile again, but that's a bit of a shameless plug. Yeah. That's probably a bit much. Or we've got like this little animated
A1. All right.
Yeah. So this is because we've all been doing in the band. We've been doing a lot of online virtual concerts, which I'm sure we'll talk about that later. So this is my A1 virtual concert background. But if you'd rather just see my boring wall, there we are.
We love your wall. Your wall isn't boring at all. We love
Actually,
your wall.
I'm not even sure this camera's straight. There we are. Ta-da! Much better.
There you go. It's a beautiful wall.
Thank you so much
for joining us, of course. Eris?
Pleasure.
Okay, Mark, let's go to the interview thing. But yes. How are you doing right now? And what keep you busy? Okay.
You know, obviously we've all been affected by this crazy pandemic. And I firstly just want to say I hope you're all doing okay. I hope you're all doing well and staying safe. It's been a challenge, but at the same time, I feel very fortunate that I'm one of those people that doesn't have to still go to work. I can work from home. But obviously I'm thinking of all the frontliners out there that are still working really hard to save people's lives and things like that. So I'm doing okay. How about you? How are you guys doing? You all right?
Oh, we're doing great, of course. Yeah. So what's been keeping you busy also? What are the things you do when you're bored?
Well, I'm one of these people, I've never been bored in my life, and I can never understand it when people say to me, oh, I'm bored. If you're bored, then you just don't have enough hobbies or enough passion, because I need 5 lifetimes to do everything I want to do.
Dang.
I'm no kidding. So I can fill up a day like nobody. I literally, you know, I create so many projects, whether it's writing new songs, creating videos, editing videos, organizing concerts with a band, and so I keep very busy. But obviously when the pandemic hit, we were actually on tour. A1 were on tour all around the UK, so we had to cut that short. We had to cut that short, obviously, and they've all been rescheduled to next year. Fortunately, so we found ourselves at home, and it was a bit of an adjustment at first. But as a writer and a producer, I spend hours and hours in the studio, sitting at the keyboard, sitting in front of screens. Anyway, so I feel bad for saying it, but lockdown is like bliss for a producer. For a music producer, you get the opportunity to work on all these projects that you haven't had time to do.
Yeah.
So I know it's been a challenge for some people, but I've loved it.
Yeah, that's good to hear. And that sounds so cool, syempre. Nag-syempre tuloy ko. Okay, you've mentioned that we've been under lockdown, right? We've had so much time to ourselves, kumbaga. So what have you discovered about yourself for the past few months under quarantine?
Okay, well, I've discovered that I'm not such a bad cook after all. Because when you're busy, you just make something quickly because, well, you've got to eat, haven't you? So I'm one of these people that I would literally allocate 15 to 20 minutes to cook some dinner. You know, I would literally, I just have to throw something in a pan, make something up quickly.
Pretty short, yeah.
It. Yeah, and then get back to work. But when you have a little bit more time, when you have a little more time on your hands, you can actually, well, I'll try mixing this with that, and I'll try mixing that. Oh, okay. Wow. So I've obviously learned something from all the years of watching my mum cook, because she's an amazing cook. She's the best.
Aww.
I know we're all going to say that about our parents, but she really is. So I've learned a lot from my mum, and I'm not such a bad cook after all. But I have discovered that I am a very bad TikTok dancer. I won't be doing any more of that.
So you joined on the hype?
No, not really. No. I kind of looked at it and I was like, yeah, that, I'm not going to do that. Yeah. And I guess I discovered that my Amazon delivery guy is my new best friend as well.
Yeah.
So that's what I've discovered in lockdown.
Yeah. Yeah. But Mark, let's talk about your cook. You said that you are a cook. What's your specialty?
Oh no! Okay, I set myself up now, but actually, it's not that exciting. Generally, anything with pasta. I hate to be boring, but it's all plant-based as well. I'm a vegetarian, so I don't eat any meat. But yeah, I love trying to find ways to make being vegetarian really enjoyable. I mean, a lot of people go, "How can you be veggie? You know, you can't." I think being a meat eater makes people a little bit lazy, because they rely on that like third of their plate to be filled with meat, and it doesn't matter about what else is on the plate as long as you've got that meat. You take away the meat, then all of a sudden you've got to get creative with your vegetables and other things that you eat. I personally find it quite easy, but in terms of my go-to is anything with coconut, anything with ginger, anything with garlic. I really like playing around with spices, because that's you know, I like flavor. I like if I eat some food and it doesn't have any flavor, it's such a disappointment. So anyway, I didn't know this was a cooking show, but this is great.
I'm feeling kind of guilty now. I'm probably never just gonna eat meat for the next 2 weeks. Okay.
Sorry.
Yeah, but I know. But Mark, how are you adjusting to the new normal as a musician?
Well. I don't think life as a musician is ever that normal anyway, and certainly not when you've been in like A1 for 20 years. I mean, our life has never been that normal. So I think the main adjustment is just finding a way to connect with the fans, because obviously normally we would be able to do concerts, live shows, meet and greets. Now all of that's gone for the time being. So I think the biggest adjustment has just been finding ways to connect with your fans. But we're so fortunate to have things like Zoom, to have IG Live, Facebook Live, where we can connect with our fans. And I know that was there before, but I think it's gone to a new level now that that's the only way we can connect with our fans. So I think the biggest and best adjustment is our ability to connect with people all over the world.